Hello everyone, welcome to the ITLS Academy. In today's lecture, we will discuss about on the topic biotechnology of ice wine production. In the previous lecture, we have discussed about the enzyme and food industry. Now let's start with the ice wine production. Let's begin with the introduction first. Ice wine is a kind of dessert wine or naturally sweet wine produced from the frozen grapes obtained after the natural freezing while the grapes are still on the vine. The origin of ice wine probably occurred by chance when winemaker tried to produce wine from frozen grapes after unsuitable climatic condition in northern area at the end of the maturity. So due to the lower yield of the grapes and the difficulty of processing, ice wine are more expensive than table wines. Ice wine is believed to have been first produced in Franconia region in 1794 after a vineyard grape froze while the monks in charge were waiting for the permission to harvest them. However, once they pressed the grape, they realized the quality of the must and the extreme sweetness. The fermentation process must have proved difficult because of high sugar content, and it is quite likely that it was impossible to fully ferment the sugar so that as a result the wine remained sweet. But it is likely that they liked it very much and perceived it as a high quality wine. Ice wine are really expensive because 3 to 4 kg of grapes are used to produce a small quantity of 375 ml bottle, equating to glass per wine or a drop per grape berry. Ice wine are produced in Canada, Germany, Australia, Switzerland and China. The greatest producer are Germany and Canada. There are few places suitable for producing the ice wine in the world. Traditionally, only 3 countries including Germany, Austria and Canada. The main ice wine producing countries are Germany and some region in Austria, Ontario in Canada, Niagara Peninsula and British Columbia's Kent Root Valley. Next is the varieties and harvesting condition. Because of high residual sugar and alcohol content in ice wine, there is a real need for high acidity to balance taste to avoid the cloying. So traditional ice wine are generally made from aromatic and acidic grape varieties. And although cold weather condition result in an absolute loss in acidity, that is the potassium tartrate crystallization, juice concentration due to ice formation could provide sufficient acidity. The aromatic varieties often used for white ice wine are Vidal Blanche, the Riesling, Sylvaner, Italian Riesling, etc. While Cabernet Franc, Merlot, Syrah, etc. are used for the red ice wines. Harvesting can be done using mechanical wine harvesters or by picking grapes by hand. Manual harvesting aids in the selection of bunches on the plot with the ability to reject those affected by pest or rotting. A mechanical process is useful to harvest at night when low temperature are a priority. It is also faster and lower in cost. Early harvesting produces higher concentration of esters and aliphatic compounds. But during harvesting, there are some problems also occur in growing the grapes, such as I'm talking about the birds. Birds are a big problem for ice wine plots because the delayed harvest makes the sweet grapes really attractive to them. Moreover, at this time, the seeds used as a food by birds become scarce, so they eat bunches of fruit and destroy the entire crops. This is normally controlled by covering canopies with thin nets, and environmental conditions can also affect the quality of the grapes, such as the wind, rain, hail, or even warm temperature during harvest make the collection of frozen grapes or grapes at suitable temperature, that is below -7 degrees Celsius, is impossible. Pests and mold can also degrade grape's quality and making it difficult to produce high quality of ice wine. Next is our topic, pressing technology and the winemaking process. The winemaking process has several key steps, such as pressing, because it is necessary to keep temperature below -7 to -8 degrees Celsius, and during the process to keep water in the pomeg and to obtain a very concentrated must. For sugar solution, a temperature of around -20 degrees Celsius is necessary to completely freeze water and sugar. Therefore, for sugar solution, the temperature of around -20 degrees is necessary to completely freeze out the water and sugar within the grape. When temperature are in the range between, we can say, -8 to -15 degrees Celsius, water is generally frozen as a pure ice crystal, and the resulting liquid is highly concentrated syrup of sugar with little water. So, if the grapes are frozen at this temperature, the syrup can be removed by pressing with a high concentrated degree, with the most of the water remaining in the pomeg as the ice crystal. Normally, ice wines are pressed in hydraulic basket presses, and it takes a long time because of the hardness of the frozen grape. Settling is a very slow process due to the syrupous and thick consistency of must. Because of high concentration level of sugar, also fermentation is very difficult stage that is prone to the sluggish fermentation because of the high concentration of sugar and extreme osmotic pressure. After fermentation, the next step includes the typical stabilization process and bottling, usually in small half bottles or even the 200 ml batches. Okay, here is the process that is showing the flow chart of ice wine making. First, the reception of the frozen grape at -11 degrees Celsius. Then we have discussed about the pressing technology by hydraulic or by manual. Frozen grapes or pomeg are being pressed by in a hydraulic pressure. Then the slow fermentation is done by yeast, dose of about 50 gram per hour liter supplementary nutrients, and it is taking for the period of 1 to 3 months. And then the stabilization, fining, filtering, and then the last step is our bottling process. Next is the fermentation and biotechnologies. When yeast are under hyperosmotic stress due to very high sugar concentration, they produce glycerol and accumulate it inside the cytoplasm to balance external osmotic pressure. Fermentation of must from frozen grapes takes a long time, that is greater than 6 weeks or sometimes several months, and value of some fermentative intermediates are normally higher than that for conventional wines. Cell growth is inhibited by hyperosmotic condition in standard must fermentation. So, the next is the acetic acid, glycerol, and total acidity formation. Standardized to metabolize sugar strongly correlate to must concentration. Acetaldehyde concentration reaches value of 4 times higher than normal wine during the first week, but later concentration is lower, due perhaps to the high volatility of such molecules and its metabolization by aldehydes dehydrogenase. The expression of several mitochondrial aldehyde dehydrogenase has been observed, and it can also affect the formation of glycerol 3-phosphate. Production of acetic acid means more than an 80% increase in total acidity. To increase the quality of ice wine fermentation, yeast selection and breeding are a powerful tool for obtaining strain or hybrids with improved performance that are better adapted to the osmotic stress of high concentrated must. The yeast strain also produces variations in the wine aromatic profile, but it is also strongly influenced by interaction between the yeast effect, vintage, and the variety. This demonstrates that different yeast species produces unique compounds or higher concentration of specific compounds relative to other treatment. The addition of nutrients, especially to increase yeast assimilable nitrogen, is normally carried out by dosing diammonium phosphate or yeast hydrosilates. Also, yeast fragments releases unsaturated lipid and vitamins that help yeast to grow and to make fermentation even under extreme conditions easier. Therefore, the choice of yeast strain has also been found to be a significant affect the accumulation of acetic acid, glycerol, and reduce sulfur odor and color. The next topic under this is the aging of ice wine. Aging on lees, AOL, is a biological technique consisting of keeping wines in contact with lees for several months or years to increase the mouthfeel by release of yeast polysaccharides and mannoproteins and to improve aromatic complexity by some yeast metabolites or because of the formation of new aromatic compounds. The lees are the death cells that have fermented the wine. The AOL of ice wine can improve its structure, increasing the integration and smoothing of acidity. Moreover, it is possible to obtain more complex sensory profile by formation of new aromatic compounds with notes of baked good and yeast. The aging on lees starts with the autolysis process by yeast enzymes that start to depolymerize cell envelope. In this process, not only the cell wall constituent but also the cytosolic content are released in vines. These yeast cell walls are formed by chitin, glucan, and mannoproteins. Yeast cell wall polysaccharides increases the mouthfeel, reduces astringency and bitterness, and improving wine softness and density. Moreover, the AOL of ice wine can improve the structure, increasing the integration and smoothing of the acidity. Moreover, the aging on lees is a reductive protecting fruitiness, and it probably helps to preserve variety of aromas in ice wine. Yeast cell wall contains the glutathione, a tripeptide with strong antioxidant properties located mainly in its thiol groups. This glutathione is currently used by many winemakers to control the oxidation and minimize the levels of SO2, which are higher in sweet wines than in dry ones. Yeast autolysis is very slow process, but is also strain dependent. So selection of a suitable strain can help speed up the process. The production of pure yeast biomasses of a single yeast culture selected for its specific positive properties for aging on lees improves the microbiological application of this technique. Moreover, the aging on lees can soften the acidity, making a better balanced wine. The use of aging on lees in ice wine can help to improve the aromatic complexity and flavor balance, and at the same time protect the aroma compounds from oxidation. The next topic under this is the sparkling ice wine. The first sparkling ice wine was made in Canada in 1998 by Inniskillen company using the Chamet method in stainless steel tank. At sensory level, the integration of CO2 bubbles reduces the sweetness and helps to improve the integration and freshness. To make the sparkling wines, there are main technologies for traditional bottle fermentation and Chamet process. Okay, these were the two processes that is used for the sparkling of ice wine. And in the first technique, the most traditional one, the partial fermentation of the sugar must be done in the water reaching the desired carbon dioxide pressure. After fermentation, the typical aging of lye stage improves the mouthfeel and aromatic complexity. As aging on lye take a long time to develop yeast autolysis and promote the formation of aromatic compounds, a period longer than 9 months is frequently recommended to reach the suitable expression. After fermentation and the aging of lye step, it is necessary to remove less lees to obtain a clean and clear product. Dosing, capping and riddling, dissolving and corking in the usually small quantities in 375 ml vacancy bottles is labor intensive. So it was some traditional method and very laborious also. But in the second method, that is the Charmet method, in which the fermentation is carried out on a bigger scale in a steel pressure tank, where this sparkling wine is settled and later transferred to the bottle under the isobaric condition. The Charmet method is easier and has lower cost compared with the traditional bottle fermentation. In both the techniques, yeast undergo a very difficult fermentation process because of high osmotic and carbon dioxide pressure. Next is the analytical controls. Various analytical method has been applied on the ice wine. The analytic measurement are a necessary approach in ice wine production for product monitoring and quality control. Conclusive analysis is a matter of high reliable and objective instrumentation, such as we can use the gas chromatography application. Gas chromatography and gas chromatography with the MS with specific sample preparation are widely used for the detection and quantification of the organic molecules and also organometallic species in ice wine, especially for the analysis of both volatile and semi-volatile compound. The entire method of for ice wine analysis did not exceed 20 minutes per sample. The GCMS has also been used to determine amino acids, and also ice wine stored for 24 years also contains some amino acids, such as the 0.9% D proline, 6.4% of galaxine, and 3% of asparagine, 1.5% alanine can be easily determined by GCMS application. The next application is LC application, that is a high performance liquid chromatography HPLC method are widely used for the analysis of many non-volatile compounds in ice wine. The technique is suitable for sugar determination and fast detection of glucose and fructose in ice wine. There are two types of sugar in six types of ice wine were determined by HPLC with the evaporative light scattering detector. The samples were analyzed on a NH2 chromatographic column. That is ammonium chromatographic column. The following phase was acetonitrile H2O water, means we have the 80% of acetonitrile and 20% of water, and the flow was 0.8 ml/min. The temperature in column detector was 40 degrees Celsius, and the injected volume for our sample was 20 microliter. The next application is FTMIR application. Using Fourier transform middle infrared spectrometry, that is the FTMIR, it is possible to analyze wine and must within a 90s time frame simultaneously on a significant number of important enological parameters such as alcohol content, relative density, extract, sugar-free extract, refractions, conductivity, glycerol, total phenol, reducing sugar, fructose, glucose, sucrose, total acid, pH value, volatile acid, total SO2, and tartaric acid, malic acid, lactic acid, and various other compounds. Sample preparation is usually easy, fast, and cheap, which include the decarbonation and cleaning by centrifugation or filtration. FTMIR is a secondary analytical method that first need to calibrate the instrument against the chemical reference method for the different component, and once the system has been cleaned or zeroed, it is a good practice to perform this standardized procedure before running the calibration sample. Our next topic is the sensory quality. In visual appearance, we are talking about visual appearance and color. The appearance is very important for a wine. Sight is the first of our sense to be used in wine tasting. The eyes introduce a wine, providing an initial reference point such as the clarity, transparency, sediment, brilliance, color, bubbles, and fluidity. Meanwhile, sight can also affect the sensitivity of smell and taste too. A glass of quality ice wine should be clear, bright enough, transparent, shiny, and refractive. The color of a wine may provide some indications of a wine's body, its age, health, and maturity. Clarity is closely related to the taste, as we have told. A cloudy wine with particles in suspension will directly and adversely affect one's taste but sensory quality. The wine will be masked by a screen of impurities and the flavor will be distorted. A cloudy wine never tastes right. It is rough and lacking in harmony. Furthermore, a haze is always a sign of spoilage for consumers. An appropriate level of wine clarity implies the level of visible impurities under analysis does not exceed the threshold of what is considered acceptable. Because there is no such things as absolute limpidity in wine. The color of wine may provide some indications of wine's body that I have told that its age, health, maturity. Generally, a color is related to the characteristics. A certain color indicates a certain type of wine. Next is our aroma profile. Ice wine has distinctive aroma characteristics varying from peach, pear, fig, green, apple, raisins, dried apricot, citrus, pineapple, lychee, mango to violet, honey, and caramel depending on its origin, grape variety, and the process vinification. Young ice wine has a lively fruity flavor. This sensory profile evolves into honey, caramel, and dried fruits notes upon aging. The complex flavor of ice wine may be a cause of following using aromatic white varieties or aromatic adequately accumulate during the slow maturity of the berry, high sugar content, enriched yeast fermentation to produce more alcohol and esters, besides being aged in barrel or aged on lees, can show more complex or evolved aromas. Ice wine is quite refreshing despite the high amount of residual sugar due to high acidity level. Many people describe it as a delicious dessert in a glass, and it is quite common for a small 375 ml bottle to be enjoyed by 6 to 8 people. Thank you for being with us. I hope you have understood all the procedures about the ice wine production. And for more information, please log on to our website www.itlsacademy.com and register yourself for summer training program.